Hello, I'm Dovev Lavie.
And I'm Uriel Stettner.
And we'll be discussing our recent paper in the strategic management journal, Ambidexterity Under Scrutiny, which examines the performance implications of balancing exploration exploitation across the firm's internal organization, alliances, and acquisitions. This paper offers important implications for research in strategy and in particular for those interested in knowledge management and organizational learning, since exploration and exploitation are fundamental organizational activities. Exploration involves developing new knowledge, whereas exploitation refers to refining existing knowledge. Both activities are essential for organizational performance, but in his seminal work, Jim March has underscored the trade-offs between these activities. Most of the literature in the past decade has advocated ambidexterity, suggesting that firms should simultaneously explore and exploit. Empirically, however, prior research has furnished mixed evidence on the merits of ambidexterity. Apparently, firms that manage to effectively achieve and maintain ambidexterity are the exception rather than the rule. So in our paper, we take a closer look at how firms seek to balance exploration and exploitation.
The fact of the matter is that most firms explore and exploit via multiple modes, including the internal organization, alliances, and acquisitions. By considering only one mode of operation, scholars may gain incomplete perspectives on the configuration of exploration and exploitation, which may explain the mixed results in the literature. In our study, we examined the interplay of exploration and exploitation across these distinct modes of operation. We raised two fundamental questions. First, are firms better off balancing exploration and exploitation within each mode of operation, or rather balance these activities across modes of operation, that is, focusing on exploration in one mode while underscoring exploitation in another? Second, if balancing exploration and exploitation across modes pays off more than balancing these activities within each mode, which mode should be used for exploration and which one for exploitation? To answer these questions, we analyze a sample of 190 software firms based in the United States and track information on all of the products that they introduce, alliances that they formed, and acquisitions that they engage in over a period of 12 years. Our sample covers 8,961 products, 10,993 alliances, and 435 acquisitions.
Consistent with the findings of Lavie, Kang, and Rosenkopf in a 2011 Organization Science paper, where I find a U-shaped effect of exploration in the alliance mode on the firm's market value, we reveal a U-shaped effect of exploration also in the internal organization and acquisition modes. These findings clearly show that a firm suffers performance decline when engaging in proportional levels of exploration exploitation in the same mode. This finding challenges the received wisdom in the literature according to which firms can enhance performance by simultaneously exploring and exploiting in product development, for instance. We find that seeking to balance exploration and exploitation within each mode undermines performance. However, a firm that balances exploration and exploitation across distinct modes, that is, exploring in one mode while exploiting in another, can enjoy the complementary benefits of exploration and exploitation and improve its performance by decoupling exploration from exploitation. Such firm can overcome the tension between conflicting routines, nurture a coherent learning environment, and promote specialization in either exploration or exploitation in a particular mode. In each mode, the firm can invest resources in one activity without sharing them with the other activity and following consistent procedures. Overall, our findings confirm that balancing exploration and exploitation across the internal organization and acquisitions enhance performance more than balancing them within each of these modes.
Still, even if one accepts the idea that firms are better off exploring in one mode while exploiting in another, should a firm use its internal organization for exploration or exploitation? Should it rely on acquisitions to explore or exploit? Our findings indicate that in the software industry at least, firms can enhance their market value by exploiting internally while exploring via alliances or acquisitions. This is the case since externally oriented modes that transcend the firm's boundaries enable the firm to benefit from exploration, whereas internally oriented modes that confine operations to the firm's boundaries increase the value of exploitation. Exploration requires the firm to move away from its core competence and minimize its reliance on prior knowledge. This is more effectively achieved via alliances and acquisitions than via the firm's internal organization. Within its internal organization, the firm can effectively engage in local search for solutions and their refinements, but boundary spanning is rather challenging. Alliances enable the firm to span boundaries by tapping into external knowledge of partners. Still, the interaction between the firm and its partner may limit the extent of exploration. This, however, is not a constraint in the case of acquisitions, which explains why they serve as an effective choice for unrelated diversification. Acquisitions can maximize the value of exploration relative to alliances, and even more so relative to the internal organization, yet limit the value of exploitation.
In sum, our study contributes to the learning literature and to research on ambidexterity by challenging the received wisdom about the merits of simultaneous exploration and exploitation within particular modes, such as in the firm's internal organization. In this sense, we relax the latent assumption about independence of different modes of operation when thinking about exploration and exploitation. We demonstrate that an optimal configuration for software firms involves pursuing exploration in an externally oriented mode while exploiting via an internally oriented mode. Therefore, our study urges scholars to carefully consider a firm's approach for balancing exploration and exploitation. It is incorrect to assume that balance is always good. Some approaches for balancing exploration and exploitation can undermine performance, whereas others can enhance it. By following our guidance, firms can enhance their knowledge management skills and improve their corporate development efforts across the internal organization, alliances, and acquisition modes. If you are interested in learning more about our research, please do not hesitate to contact us. Thank you.